Starting forward, the 6'2 senior, number 0, Nakai Thomas Fauntleroy.
Good afternoon, Chief fans.
GTV.
Here we go. We have the seventh place game with the TOC between the Kickapoo Chiefs and the Bolivar Liberators.
And this time,
this is actually an interesting matchup considering that Kickapoo and Bolivar were both respectively the blue and gold tournament champions.
Also,
Kickapoo was the gold tournament champions and Bolivar was the blue tournament champions. So this is the first time that the blue and gold tournament champions have met. So this will be interesting to see who really is the blue and gold champion. Chucky, you have anything to say?
Well, we got it set up. The time for tip-off.
And today there will be no scoreboard issues. And I promise, and I'll show you that scoreboard right now. And as we can see, it says Liberators and Chiefs. So there you go, guys.
As both teams are 0-2, fighting to not get last place and not go 0-3 in this tournament. Predictions, who do you think is going to win? As Bolivar introduces their starters.
I think that Kickapoo will, I think they will clutch out a win. I really do. I've been really impressed with Bolivar this past weekend, but honestly, Kickapoo, I think, has the right pieces and right tools to beat Bolivar. And like we said last night, Kickapoo needs to stop number 22. He has the smoothest stroke, best shot of the team. So if they stop him, I believe that the Kickapoo Chiefs will win this game.
His name is Bryce Cougar, but also someone to look for. I'm Oliver number 33, Brandon Emmer. He's 6'6". He's played very well in this tournament. Been a problem for some teams. He's got size. He can post up. We'll see how Kickapoo matches up against that. As you know, the star players have been critical.
I agree.
As opening tip is about to start, I hope the Chiefs can pull off a victory for you guys watching. We need to get a Vic 0-2 in the tournament of champions. So hopefully we can go 1-2 and secure seventh place. I think the keys to the game for Kickapoo, better shot selection, attacking the rim more, and stopping Bolivar's big guys and their best players on the team. Hope that they can match up well. And the keys for Bolivar is to stop Jared Ritter. He's got a sweet stroke. He scored, actually last night, Jared Ritter scored 24 points. So obviously that's going to be one key for Bolivar, top of the issue for them. If Bolivar has good ball movement, forces Kickapoo in some foul trouble. Kickapoo only played 8 players last game, so they don't have much of a bench, not much depth. So here we go. This Bolivar will gain possession. All right. Bryce Cougar, number 22, you're talking about. That's him with the
and
ball.
Thomas Fauntleroy almost with the steal, but knocks out of bounds.
And that is the guy who we're talking about with the sweet stroke, Bryce Cougar. Remember the name.
I'm pretty sure we'll be saying his name quite a few times over this next hour.
Along with Jared Ritter, if I do say so myself.
Exactly. Don't discount Jared Ritter. Jared Ritter probably has one of the sweetest strokes on Kickapoo's team.
And he's the biggest guy on the team, too, besides Mitch Closser.
Exactly.
Ooh, mishit old pass. Could have had an open three there. They're going to go down to number... they're going to trap him. Force it away from him.
And
it'll still be
still Bolivar's ball.
But that's who I was talking about, Brandon Emmert. They're going to go to him a lot, and Kickapoo smartly double teams from the beginning, forces the knock out of bounds. They can't let him go, and he's a big body. Kickapoo with good defense so far as Bolivar's moving the ball around, holding their ground. There's Cougar, the guy you're talking about.
And misconnects, and Travis Rokolek with the rebound.
Good box out on Emmert there. Kickapoo gets down close, and they're going to go Jared Ritter instantly, but no good. And there's Cameron Davis on the tip-in. Good start for Kickapoo on the first offense possession, getting the second chance. Now they have the 2-0 lead over the Bolivar Liberators. As we got the scoreboard fixed this time, credit to Matt.
You're welcome. We
Maddie
won't have
B,
a
sorry.
Debacle or debacle with the scoreboard tonight.
Another good defensive possession. They're going to go back down low to Emmert. Swing it around. Nothing going. Kickapoo's holding their ground on defense. And there is a drive by Johnny Scott. He's a 6'2 senior for Bolivar. Bolivar's got a lot of experience, a lot of seniors. This experienced starting lineup. They know how to play. They've played a lot. Kick out to Cameron Davis for the three, no good. As Emmer gets the rebound, he's going to round transition. He's going to stop the ball, bring it back out, get to the point guard. Good job by the big man to slow it down, let Bolivar run their offense.
Mm-hmm.
Here's Kruger in the corner, drives it in. Nothing there. A good cutoff by Cameron Davis. Bolivar, not much offense going. A lot of there, nice drive. Oh, and a blocker trying to swing
back. Oh, and gets it back. Stake by Kickapoo.
He had the ball, but it just slipped out of his hands right back to Ember, and he got the easy layup. Unforced error, and that's not what the Chiefs needed there.
No.
As Johnson went a little high pass, but Thomas Frontois was able to pick it up, and he's going to shake the jumper. And
ooh, that looked pretty.
He ties the game at 4 with 5:05 to go here in the first quarter.
Remember that reminded me of a little bit?
Who? Steph Curry?
Steve Nash.
Okay.
Some vintage Steve Nash.
Steve Nash, very good player. I thought you were going to say Steph Curry, but
nope.
My bad.
Steve Nash definitely liked the fadeaway. Johnny Scott with the three, no good.
Lokolek with the rebound. Dangerous pass there, but Raider was able to see it. Now he's going to run the four. Little floater, no good. And now he picks up the foul. Jared Rooner, though, showing a little bit of ball handling. A little more versatile than just a shooter. That's his first foul of the game. Good defense by both teams to start off this game. Not much of a crowd for this first game, just because it's the last place game, and everyone wants to come tonight for Oak Hill.
Oak Hill and Sierra Canyon.
Oak Hill, that'll be a good game. I wish we could watch.
Broadcast to you, but, you know, we can't.
And that's
Emmert. CBS rights.
Emmert, tough man to stop. Big body, as I said before, he's going to be hard to contain. Barr's going to look to go to him a lot. As Karen Davis has the open three, no
and
good.
And he still can't connect. Vokalek with the rebound and just loses it going up, but thankfully it goes off a Bolivar player, so it will stay down at Kikapu's end.
Good offensive rebound by Vokalek, but good job Bolivar recovering. Strip it from him with those quick hands.
Mm-hmm.
Not sure who that was, but that was still a very good play. Want to look for Jared Rader curls. He's going to shoot the three. Tough shot.
Ooh.
He nails it. That's a play that they like to run. Jared Ritter curls off into the corner and shoots the three, but that was a tough shot, but able to get it to go.
The only player who really consistently connects on threes is Jared Ritter, so for Kickapoo, you really only want Jared Ritter shooting threes.
And it's funny because he's one of the tallest guys on the team, so you wouldn't think a big man would shoot, but he can.
But that makes him really versatile and definitely a good D1 recruit, if I say so myself.
And there's a three by Case Jones, but that was not a pretty looking shot. Little rush. Didn't really have anything going for it. It's
Cameron Davis. A nice pass by Isaac Johnson.
That's what he does, the point guard on this team. Playing very well for Kickapoo and down the other end.
Kickapoo got lazy getting back on defense, and that leads to an easy 2 points for Bolivar.
9-8 lead for Kickapoo with 3:09 to go. He's going to look to go to Ritter, but the denial. Going to do a little pick and roll here. And Kiku's going to reset.
Comes Thomas Frontroy, passes it to Ritter.
I thought he might have shot
Davis.
That.
I thought he was going to, too.
He could probably hit that.
And
as Isaac Johnson, my bad, shoots the three, but that's no good. Wasn't the best looking shot.
No.
Some Kiku struggle with a lot of threes, forced threes that they don't really need to take.
Mm-hmm.
As here's Bryce Kruger, ooh, close to a travel there, but kept his foot down.
Johnny's
they go down to Brennan Emmert again. They're going to do a little bit of a double team.
Kick out to Johnny Scott. Johnny Scott misses the three. And Travis Vokalek with the rebound.
So Vokalek does. He's a good rebounder.
He is a very good rebounder.
Not much of a score, but it is more the defensive type stuff. He's got a big body.
Mm-hmm.
As Jared Ritter, another three, and that's buckets. Sweet looking shot there. That was a beautiful swish. As Kickapoo this time gets back on defense. Doesn't let Bolivar get any easy transition scores. 12-8 lead for the
Chiefs. Just like we've stated, Jared Ritter's the only one who has been able to connect consistently for Kickapoo and
travel on Kruger.
He is. He's the only person to connect on three-pointers for Kickapoo this evening, and that has been two three-pointers for him.
as the Chiefs with a 12-8 lead. We haven't seen with a lead in a while. It feels good.
No, it does feel good to have a lead once in a while, especially at the TOC. So right now in the Battle of the Blue and Gold Tournament Champions, Kickapoo is winning 12-8.
I feel like this is going to be a very good game.
Yeah, very good competition.
As some subs for Kickapoo, as Roberson misses a shot.
Ritter
Roberson
gets the rebound and throws it away. And here comes
Blakesy. There was a tip. As Blakesy also came in. And Mitch Kloster, the three subs
and
in for
Kickapoo. And he throws a lazy pass and is stolen. Johnny Scott.
And there's a foul.
Ooh. Sorry, I didn't switch my camera angle right there. I was really involved in the play. But
looks like he might got hit in the face a little bit.
But if you noticed, it looked like he got all ball. But Johnny Scott is really shaken up on the play. Looks like maybe he got hit in the face. And he's having to come out. And maybe it's his contact. Maybe he got scratched. Maybe the contact got scratched. Who knows? Coach Drippy with a nice gesture of condoling Johnny Scott.
Sportsmanship. Something happened. But there's a substitution, Case Jones, as he will shoot the free throws for the injured
Johnny
Scott.
Just a quick note on Coach Drippy. He actually is a really kind guy. I mean, he teaches a driver's ed program at our school.
And, fun class.
And, you know, he really cares about his kids, really cares about everybody. So, you know, that's his personality. So, really nice job and showing of character by Coach Rippey.
The second free throw goes. As he only gets one out of two, 12-9 lead, three-point lead for the Chiefs. 1:30 to go in the first quarter. Cameron Davis, a little drive, pull-up jumper.
Ooh,
tough shot, but he
nice.
Made it. Being aggressive. We'll see what ball runs here. If they go to Emmer, I wouldn't be surprised. As they have Mitch Kloster on him, another big body. That's what Kickapoo needs. Doing a good job denying. Now swinging around, this is Conley Garrison, number zero, junior point guard. Pretty well, good player for Bolivar. Good hands by Mitch Kloster, knock it away. Kickapoo really holding the ground right now in this defensive possession, not letting Bolivar get anything going. As again, there is no shot clock, so Bolivar has all the time, so they got to keep applying the defensive pressure. Can't let up. Ooh,
Kruger,
nice split.
Nice split and baskets.
That was a very, very nice move. I'll be honest, that was pretty slick. Split right through him. Looked a little like Steph Curry there.
I don't know if I'd go Steph Curry-esque, but it did look pretty nice, pretty slick. And like we said, Kruger has the best shot, best stroke of the team.
You can't leave him on the three-point line, but he can also drive it, as he showed there. Perverso players, Kickapoo will, in fact, hold for the last shot, try to extend on this three-point lead. 8 seconds to go, time winding down. Cameron Davis going to go to Ritter, and he's going to shoot another
three. And no good, and it looks
Kloster
like...
Kloster with the tip, but nothing. And I don't think that shot would count, but Blissey kind of threw it up there. But... not a bad first quarter for the Chiefs. 14-11 lead. They have the lead.
No,
this is definitely a very winnable game.
And if you're Kiku right now, you had the lead. Thank goodness.
You know, finally.
It's 14-11. Kiku over Bolivar. So this game has had good tempo. Nice shot selection, I think, by Kickapoo. Other than the occasional
three-pointer,
but most of the three-pointers have come off of Jay Ritter's hands, and that's an okay play, I believe.
It is. And with a 14-11 lead, Chiefs will be right back after this.
You're watching Chief TV. Up here in Studio 240, Chief TV. Up here in Chief TV. Up here in Studio 241, you've got every opportunity to become a media expert. Whether you're interested in traditional broadcast journalism, news reporting, or short filmmaking, music video, animation, audio production, make a great demo CD. Up here in Chief TV, you'll learn it all. In other words, we make your YouTube videos professional grade. Consider Chief TV broadcast journalism when you're scheduling. Broadcast journalism 1 and 2 count for credit under communication arts, and they teach you career skills you can't find anywhere else here at KHS. Chief TV, up here in Studio 2.
And we are back. This ball, we're still in the huddle. Kid, we're ready to play some ball. Second quarter.
Quarter going to get underway here.
Our
very
time is
shortly.
Time is winding down. This is the last game we can broadcast. Let's make it last.
Last game for the TOC for us.
Us broadcasters, just students at Kickapoo, just like you guys. Let's see what Kickapoo does here. The start of the second quarter. Always with the start of a quarter, you want to start on the right foot because it could lead the direction of your team in this quarter.
Davis with the drive, kick out to Blakesy.
Open three, no good. That was a good shot, though. Good penetration by Davis. I can't argue with that shot.
Even though it was a miss, I take that play selection and play call all day long. Even an open three, at some point, you're able to hit it.
Kickapoo needs to do more of that. Because those are more high percentage shots than those jacked up threes that they've been shooting all tournament.
Yeah, the dribble penetration and a nice turnover by Bolivar. Steal. So here comes Johnson.
I think he changed numbers to 10. Wasn't he 4 before?
I believe he was 4 last night, so he changed numbers for some reason.
Do you have any idea? Because I don't.
I don't have any ideas either.
But he's now rocking number 10, and Thomas, almost got his hands on it. Thomas Fontoy, sorry. Keep forgetting, that's my bad. It's Emerald again. They're going to double team. Finds the open man.
And can't hit the three.
And that was John Michael Cates who shot that three. Number 20, but
Davis
he couldn't get that
floor.
To go. As Blasey, he's going to shoot the three. That wasn't the best shot there.
E. That's all I have to say to that.
E is right. E. And, ooh, nice pass back.
No.
Krueger open.
Yep.
The sweet stroke, you can't leave
just
him open.
Like you said,
they forgot
Krueger
about it.
Left him open. Sweet stroke. Three easy points for Bolivar right there.
As there falls down and an offensive foul.
On Johnson?
I believe so. Illegal screen. As that three ties the game at 14. Not the best start for the Chiefs.
But you know what? For Bolivar, it's a pretty good start considering they've done some pretty good defensive work down at their end of the floor, and then also getting Krueger involved with that three-point shot really helps.
As Ritter will come back in and replace Blaisky, along with Vogelek, who will replace Mitch Klosser. Ball working at a score here, they'll retake the lead.
Looks like Johnny Scott is back in, so whatever happened to him,
he's okay, which
he
is good
fouled,
to know.
He is okay, which is good to know.
As he's going to get the ball back. Actually, he might do a little post-up here. No. They're going to shoot a three. John Michael, no good.
And here comes Thomas Fontoroy. Davis trying to get it to Ritter.
Knocked
and
away.
And it is still Kinkley's ball.
It's Derek Robertson coming for Travis Vogelek. Give Kinkley some more athleticism, some more offensive firepower. They could use some scoring now with a tie game. Because Davis is going to go right down to Ritter. And now,
gets his own rebound and then loses it.
Good hustle there to get the rebound, just couldn't control the ball. As Emirates going to check back in, the big guy for Bolivar. And then hopefully they can stop him. They've done a good job containing him so far. He does have 6 points, but they've been going to him a lot, so only having 6 points. And one of those was on that easy layup when there was that turnover in the backcourt. So he should probably only have 4. I'm going to go down low to him again.
Ooh, that was a nice pass by Johnny Scott. And the Liberators.
Ritter was in front. The
Liberators take the lead.
16-14, not what Kickapoo needs here. They're leaving Roberson open.
Thought about it. And Ritter.
It's fouled and one. Nice little turnaround jump shot there. Ritter already with 8 points on the game. Good start. Half of the Chiefs' points.
And he can make this 9 if he makes this free throw.
Almost already being double digits. Kind of like a Cody Riley game, first game we broadcasted.
Yeah. Cody Riley was definitely the kryptonite for the Kickapoo Chiefs, scored 30 on them. Hopefully Jared Ritter can become the kryptonite for Bolivar.
And he is here tonight. He will be here tonight in the championship game.
He will.
I would recommend you guys watch that if you can come to JQH.
And last night, Sierra Canyon did beat Jason Tatum and Chaminade. So, definitely, Sierra Canyon is not a team to be messed around with.
You can give Kickapoo a little bit of slack.
And you can't take them lightly, even though they don't have Ira Lee, who transferred out, or Marvin Bagley because of eligibility rules. Still, somehow made it to the championship game and playing Oak Hill Academy for the final tonight. So tune into that. That's at 10 o'clock at night on CBS.
Zach Johnson will pass to Ritter and gets
buckets.
The shot to go. The Chiefs now extend their lead to 3, 19-16, as Ritter's got 11 now. He's had a good start, sweet stroke. Bolivar's going to need to stop him if they want to be able to
win this game.
Because so far he's off to
and
a hot start.
Emerson trying to post up Mitch Klauser.
There's Kruger. But he can't make that one. Lucky there. He had an open
Very
three.
Lucky. He looked like it was good from my angle.
It did. Just a little short.
And Thomas Fauntleroy with the drive and foul. And could not get that connect. But two charity strike.
Sure is.
So he's going to shoot a pair. And hopefully he connects on both of these to extend the Chiefs lead to 21-16.
5-point lead. I believe that'd be their largest of the game. I could be wrong, though. It's either 5 or 6.
That is the biggest lead of the game.
Makes the first swoosh. Look nice.
You know, it does feel pretty good that none of these teams are being blown out or pretty close, you know.
You know, they get to play a competitive game.
Exactly. And that's what the tournament champion is all about, just being competitive and watching good basketball. And he makes both of them.
Couldn't have said it better myself.
Thomas Fauntleroy with 3 points. On the night so far.
Kickapoo with the 21-16 lead.
Last night, Thomas Fauntleroy scored 10 points for the Chiefs. So
double digits.
Yeah, double digit score. So that was pretty good considering they were playing good competition.
As Klauser, foul. Well, got a little too aggressive there, but not a bad idea to try and knock it away. Just got to be careful about that.
But I like the aggression, though.
Yes, you were right. But Thomas Fauntleroy scored 10 more than his number, zero.
Emerson with the basket.
There's a timeout by Bolivar as they cut the lead down to 3. 10 points now for Brandon Emmert, which is not the start that Kickapoo wants. They don't want him to get going. But
and
on
he
the
has
other
10 points too.
But on the other hand, Jitter has 11, so both teams not doing a very good job containing the best players on the team. But with Kickapoo with a 21-18 lead over Bolivar, the 7 points game, I think the Chiefs, yeah, they can win this.
Definitely.
Bolivar, though, is not a team to be afraid of, or not to shy away from. Kickapoo cannot take it easy, as they've seen here, only a 3-point lead. They got to keep up pressure. Even if they build a lead, Bolivar could come back. This is so fun, isn't it, Matty B? Sad it has to end, though.
Hey, we still have 2 quarters left.
I know, but this is the last game. Maybe we'll get some support and do some Kickapoo home games.
I think that's the plan. So
I'm okay with that.
So I think you'll be seeing us in a 3-point for Thomas Fauntleroy.
I think it's the first one he's made, because I've seen him shoot a lot and he hasn't made any, but confident,
you know,
there.
If Thomas Fauntleroy can start hitting threes and Jared Ritter continues hitting threes, I think this game will be in Kickapoo's favor. Nice cut.
As Kickapoo will live and die by a 3-pointer, if they can make him, there will be living. As they have a 6-point lead now, Kruger with the spin, good kick
nice
out.
Nice kick out, and air ball. And but Emmert gets the rebound. Are they calling a foul on Klauser?
Klauser's got a box out there, but Emmert, big body.
Mm-hmm.
But Kickapoo making some threes, and probably shooting about 40-50%, if I had to say so myself. Much better than the last two games they played. As Emmert will go to the line, already with 10 points, make that 11. He's also, in the previous games I saw Bolivar, Emmert, not only is he like a post-up guy, you know, I've seen him shoot too. Like, he can shoot threes, he can shoot jumpers, so if Kickapoo slacks off on him, doesn't want him to get in the post, he'll make him pay. As you can see here, he misses that one though. And the rebound will stay with Bolivar. As Coach Herbie talking to the ref there, I think he's a little angry. I think there was a little bit of a push there. I'm not sure. As they're going to go right back to the man. Oh, Isaac Johnson read that pass. As he's going to get the easy layup. Try to dunk it a little, but.
No, didn't want to risk it.
Yeah, just go for the safe layup, unless it's
Johnny
an absolute
Scott
blowout.
And good.
Nice little shot by Conley Garrison there.
Cuts the Chiefs lead to 4.
Bolivar really likes to get out and run, and Kickapoo's having a little bit of trouble getting back on defense. As a travel there on Vokalek, not what Kickapoo needed. They had a 6-point or 7-point lead, and now all of a sudden, Bolivar can just cut down to 1 just like that. So Bolivar's going to work the ball around. A little high screen and roll at the free throw line. Trying to get Emmert some touches, and he gets the ball here, but not close to the basket where he'd like to be. There's a little pull-up shot by Johnny Scott. No good. Emmert, tough over Vokalek. Coach Trippy is furious right now with the rebounding. Emmert is just bullying over Kickapoo right now. As Vokalek just couldn't box him out. He tried, but just too big of a body. Six fouls now on Kickapoo. As Isaac Blaise is going to check back into the game. As he's going to replace Travis Vokalek. Having a lot of trouble stopping him. He has 12 points already. If they could have limited them, the Chiefs could have a pretty big lead right now. He's able to knock down both free throws. 2 minutes to go. Kickapoo with the 26-24 lead over Bolivar. Close first half. This is going to be a good game.
Jared Ritter with the jumper, and it's good.
That's what he does. He's got 13 in the match. Emmert's game high. They're both tied right now. The big men are being very effective for both teams so far this afternoon. Bolivar does a lot of perimeter moving the ball around, trying to set up the big guy. As Kruger gets the ball in the corner, going to work it back around the perimeter again. It's Kickapoo and a lot of switching, and they're going back down low to their guy, and they can't not stop him. Every opportunity they get, they're going to go down low to Emmert. It's too big of a body for Kickapoo to handle. It's always great to have a talented big man like Emmert. As Ritter, he's going to step out for a three.
No
good there. Wasn't able to get that one. A little rush there. And there's a turnover now. Cameron Davis, good defense, knocked it away off of Bolivar. Knocked it off Johnny Scott. It'll be interesting to see if Kickapoo holds for the last shot here. 48 seconds. If they wanted to, they could. But I feel like they're going to take a shot here.
I just say just keep going with your offense. Don't try to hold for the shot.
And there's Ritter with the smaller man on him. Just
Ritter
right over him. Just bullied over Case Jones. He's got the very nice height advantage. Case Jones is only 5'9". Jared Ritter is 6'7". 5'9 is about our height, so if I had to guard Jared Ritter, I wouldn't enjoy that much.
Nope.
Ooh, yeah, Isaac Johnson, another steal.
Scott.
Get into the passing lane. They have transition. He's going to drive it. Nice little shot. No, and Ritter,
Ritter rolls it in.
It's now Kickapoo with a 6-point lead, 32-26. There's a three, and no good. Kickapoo ends the half on a nice little run there.
As the half is over, Kickapoo Chiefs 32, Bolivar Liberators 26. 6-point lead for the Chiefs. That feels pretty good if you're a Chiefs fan.
It does. Hopefully we can get the win, get the 7th place. 1-2 in the TLC. That's not bad.
That's not bad at all. And considering that we're playing a blue and gold champion, the counterpart, we can definitely see who is
the real champion
of the blue and gold tournament. And with that, Charles and I will be back with your halftime stats in about four to five minutes. So with that, we will go to break. Thank you.
Welcome to Kickapoo High School in Springfield, Missouri. This is our new digital high-definition student center. This is our student body. Every day, 2,000 students and staff members walk through these hallways. Kickapoo High School in Springfield, Missouri. This is our new digital high-definition student center. This is our student body. Every day, 2,000 students and staff members walk through these hallways and gather here for lunch. What does that mean for your local business? A captive audience ready to watch your promotion every single school day. Kickapoo Media prides itself on producing great student content with a professional touch. We're ready to help your company grow by showing your advertisement right here in the hallways every single day. We're a nonprofit organization and we're tax deductible friendly. So if you'd like to help out Kickapoo High School and the community you work in, we'd sure love to help your business grow. Hi, I'm Kyle Loudis. I'm the director here at Kickapoo High School Broadcast Communications. For the last 10 years, we've been raising funds for our students through local commercials and advertisements right here in the hallways at the POO. My students are ready, willing, and able to produce your high school-centric commercial. You may not know this, but Chief TV broadcast journalism costs nearly $6,000 per semester to operate. So consider helping us with a donation. So that's the pitch. Hopefully we can help you out, we can shoot a commercial for you, or you can give us a pre-produced commercial you've already had done. Either way, consider showing your commercial right here in the hallways of Kickapoo High School. Thanks, gang. We'll see you soon. Welcome to Kickapoo High School in Springfield, Missouri. This is our new digital high-definition student center. This is our student body. Every day, 2,000 students and staff members walk through these hallways and gather here for lunch. What does that mean for your local business? A captive audience ready to watch your promotion every single school day. Kickapoo Media prides itself on producing great student content with a professional touch. We're ready to help your company grow by showing your advertisement right here in the hallways every single day. We're a nonprofit organization and we're tax deductible friendly. So if you'd like to help out Kickapoo High School and the community you work in, we'd sure love to help your business grow. Hi, I'm Kyle Loudis. I'm the director here at Kickapoo High School Broadcast Communications. For the last 10 years, we've been raising funds for our students through local commercials and advertisements right here in the hallways at the POO. My students are ready, willing, and able to produce your high school-centric commercial. You may not know this, but Chief TV broadcast journalism costs nearly $6,000 per semester to operate. So consider helping us with a donation. So that's the pitch. Hopefully we can help you out, we can shoot a commercial for you, or you can give us a pre-produced commercial you've already had done. Either way, consider showing your commercial right here in the hallways of Kickapoo High School. Thanks, gang. We'll see you soon.
You're watching Chief TV. Up here in Studio 241, you've got every opportunity to become a media expert. Whether you're interested in traditional broadcast journalism news reporting, or short filmmaking, music video, animation, audio production, make a great demo CD. Up here in Chief TV, you'll learn it all. In other words, we make your YouTube videos professional grade. Consider Chief TV broadcast journalism when you're scheduling. Broadcast Journalism 1 and 2 count for credit under Communication Arts, and they teach you career skills you can't find anywhere else here at KHS. At Kickapoo Chief TV, we do stuff that matters. Join Broadcast Journalism today. You're watching Chief TV. Up here in Studio 241, you've got every opportunity to become a media expert. Whether you're interested in traditional broadcast journalism news reporting, or short filmmaking, music video, animation, audio production, make a great demo CD. Up here in Chief TV, you'll learn it all. In other words, we make your YouTube videos professional grade. Consider Chief TV broadcast journalism when you're scheduling. Broadcast Journalism 1 and 2 count for credit under Communication Arts, and they teach you career skills you can't find anywhere else here at KHS. At Kickapoo Chief TV, we do stuff that matters. Join Broadcast Journalism today. You're watching Chief TV. Up here in Studio 241, you've got every opportunity to become a media expert. Whether you're interested in traditional broadcast journalism news reporting, or short filmmaking, music video, animation, audio production, make a great demo CD. Up here in Chief TV, you'll learn it all. In other words, we make your YouTube videos professional grade. Consider Chief TV broadcast journalism when you're scheduling. Broadcast Journalism 1 and 2 count for credit under Communication Arts, and they teach you career skills you can't find anywhere else here at KHS. At Kickapoo Chief TV, we do stuff that matters. Join Broadcast Journalism today. You're watching Chief TV. Up here in Studio 241, you've got every opportunity to become a media expert. Whether you're interested in traditional broadcast journalism, news reporting, or short filmmaking, music video, animation, audio production, make a great demo CD. Up here in Chief TV, you'll learn it all. In other words, we make your YouTube videos professional grade. Consider Chief TV broadcast journalism when you're scheduling. Broadcast Journalism 1 and 2 count for credit under Communication Arts, and they teach you career skills you can't find anywhere else here at KHS. At Kickapoo Chief TV, we do stuff that matters. Join Broadcast Journalism today. You're watching Chief TV. Up here in Studio 241, you've got every opportunity to become a media expert. Whether you're interested in traditional broadcast journalism, news reporting, or short filmmaking, music video, animation, audio production, make a great demo CD. Up here in Chief TV, you'll learn it all. In other words, we make your YouTube videos professional grade. Consider Chief TV broadcast journalism.
We are back as the Ballver, I forgot what they're called, are finishing up the performance.
As the Parkview Lassies are coming off the field.
Parkview?
Yeah, the Parkview Lassies, as they're coming off the court right now, we will be giving to you the halftime stats between the Kickapoo Chiefs and the Ballver Liberators. So, with that, let's go off of what Kickapoo is lacking in. Still, same story, the three-point field goals. They are 3 for 10, so 30% for the half. But that's okay because Ballver is 2 for 10, so 20%. Each team is shooting 50% on field goals. Kickapoo is 13 for 26, and Ballver is 10 for 20. And the free throw percentage for Ballver is 4 for 6, and for Kickapoo, it's 3 for 3. Charles?
All right. My first half thoughts, as you said, three-point shot. Neither team's really making them, but the field goal percentage, 50%, both pretty good. If I just, Jared Ritter, Kickapoo, he's got 17 points. He's 7 of 12 from the field, 2 of 4 from 3. Really the star of the first half for Kickapoo. Ballver's had trouble stopping him, but Sin goes for Ballver. They have Brandon Emmer, 6 of 7 from the floor. He's got 5 rebounds to go along with 15 points. Really been kryptonite for Kickapoo, kind of like the other two players.
But there's been really no one to compliment Emmer, as the next highest scorer is 5 points by Bryce Krueger. But for Kickapoo, Nakai Thomas Fontaroy actually has 7 points, so a little bit closer gap for the 17 and 7. So that's 24 of the Chiefs 32, so that's a pretty good stat right there.
But Ballver, they might get a little tired. They only played 6 guys in the first half. A lot of all the starters played at least 13 or more minutes, so 16 minutes and a half, fatigue might set in for Ballver. And those are your first half stats.
And with that, we will send you back to our commercials.
In about a minute.
For about a minute 45, we will be back.
So for the second half.
Let's begin.
Welcome to Kickapoo High School in Springfield, Missouri. Kickapoo High School in Springfield, Missouri. This is our new digital high-definition student center. This is our student body. Every day, 2,000 students and staff members walk through these hallways and gather here for lunch. What does that mean for your local business? A captive audience ready to watch your promotion every single school day. Kickapoo Media prides itself on producing great student content with a professional touch. We're ready to help your company grow by showing your advertisement right here in the hallways every single day. We're a nonprofit organization and we're tax deductible friendly. So if you'd like to help out Kickapoo High School and the community you work in, we'd sure love to help your business grow. Hi, I'm Kyle Loudis. I'm the director here at Kickapoo High School Broadcast Communications. For the last 10 years, we've been raising funds for our students through local commercials and advertisements right here in the hallways at the POO. My students are ready, willing, and able to produce your high school-centric commercial. You may not know this, but Chief TV broadcast journalism costs nearly $6,000 per semester to operate. So consider helping us with a donation. So that's Kickapoo High School in Springfield, Missouri. This is our new digital high-definition student center. This is our student body. Every day, 2,000 students and staff members walk through these hallways and gather here for lunch. What does that mean for your local business? a captive audience ready to watch your promotion every single school day. Kickapoo Media prides itself on producing great Kickapoo High School in Springfield, Missouri. This is our new...
And we are back.
And here we go. This is the third quarter between the Kickapoo Chiefs and the Bolivar Liberators.
We got a little bit of music going on here. A little surprise there as it ends. Nice round of applause. As well, we'll start the second half with the ball here. We'll see if Kickapoo can get a stop. If I was Bolivar, I think they're going to look for you-know-who.
Yeah, Brandon Emmert.
They're going to try. There they go.
There
already.
They go. Brandon Emmert, just like we said. He's posting up.
But they got the double
and
team.
And kick out and tipped. Almost a turnover. And
no good, but Emmert with the rebound.
And nice job drawing the foul there.
Kickapoo had the ball, but had it tipped away, but just they couldn't come up with
that
it.
That brings his total to 17 points. Mm. Brandon Emmert is having a monster game against Kickapoo right now.
That was pretty killer right there. Kickapoo almost had a turnover. Could have had transition to score, but now a possible three-point play. As the lead is cut down to three now, 32-29.
That's a pretty good start for Bolivar, if I do say so myself, right out of the halftime locker room, getting 3 points off of that play.
Let's see what Kickapoo runs here. Isaac Johnson to Thomas Fontoy. I got you. Don't worry.
Davis, no good.
Sorry, I was looking at the stats here. I wasn't paying attention to the
Johnny
game.
Scott, again, no good. And
they get
Ritter
the rebound.
With the rebound.
And there's Johnson. Is that counts and one? I think that will.
And I think it's counting.
That was a nice shot there.
That was a good
job.
Nice control. You could see Isaac Johnson was in the locker room, if you might say. Took some strength to put that back up as he was getting fouled.
Good word choice there, but Kickapoo, Isaac Johnson is going to get that three-point play right back.
I hope so. And there we go.
Lead back up to six now, 35-29, as the scoreboard here says.
And our very own scoreboard that says Liberators.
Yes, it does.
So thank goodness we have had no technical difficulties today. So pretty good day so far for us, and a pretty good day for Kickapoo, even though Brandon Emmert has been having his way down low.
Kickapoo's had no answer.
It's weird. I think Kickapoo has no answer for any bigs. So if they want to make a deep run into the postseason for the Missouri State title, they really need to fix how to stop big men.
That would help if they had their own big man, but Isaac Johnson, the shot, no good. This rebound will go to Bolivar now. Kickapoo is playing good defense. It's just the offensive rebounds by Emmert. See, look, another tip. They can't control it. Roy been killer. They could have a much more controlling lead if they were able to contain him and limit the offensive rebound second chances.
I couldn't agree more.
That Bolivar has had so far this afternoon. Bolivar's going to run it around the perimeter.
Just like usual.
A Kruger little drive.
Kruger with the drive.
No foul. Good sportsmanship.
I think they called a foul.
No foul.
Did they? No, they didn't. I guess I said it was off of Kruger, so kick two ball.
Good sportsmanship by Davis to help him up. He had the right idea to drive it. I think he just slipped and just went away from him, but that was a good play by Kruger. That's what I would do if I could, drive it in. Unless I had the open shot, as Johnson takes it in.
Wow.
Starting to be a little more aggressive to start the second half. I think Coach Rippey addressed to Johnson, we need you. And I think so far he's been up to the challenge.
And that brings Johnson's point total up to seven. And the shot from the elbow.
Connolly Garrison knocks that down. A little back and forth here. Kickapoo can't really take over a big lead, but still able to maintain the lead 33-37. As Ritter catch and shoot three, no good. No offensive rebound for Kickapoo. They haven't really had any second chances. But on the other end, Bolivar's had some offensive rebounds, some second chances. That's a factor. That's really been hurting Kickapoo this game.
You know whose name we haven't called out in a little bit? That man right there, Brandon Emmert. And still, Bolivar's possession.
He's been working hard, but I feel like fatigue's going to hit him soon because he's going to pretty much play this entire second half. I don't think they have anyone to sub in for him.
No.
He We'll see if he can hold it up.
Brandon Emmert actually has played 15 minutes in the first half. So he played pretty much the whole half, and he's played the whole half so far. He's played the whole quarter so far. So
as Bryce Cooper is going to get the layup off the inbounds play, and they're going to start double teaming Ritters. He's going to shoot. Not a good shot there.
Air ball.
Got to look to pass in that situation. Didn't really have anywhere to go. Good ball team by Bolver. Kind of surprised Ritter didn't know what to do with it.
Ooh, he got Isaac Johnson up in the air. And Brandon Emmert.
They're going to put Ritter on him this time, but just muscling over him.
Ritter with the block.
A foul.
And a foul. You know, what Jared Ritter really needs to improve, though, is just to get a little bit bigger, get more muscle on him in the offseason, so he can't get bullied just like how Brendan bullied him right there.
Really been hard to stop, a lot like Cody Riley, if I do say so, from Sierra Canyon.
Mm-hmm.
He's already got 20 points. But he can't make that free throw. Coach Rippey hasn't really had an answer. He doesn't really know how to stop Emmert.
I would put Mitch Kloster back on Emmert, because Mitch, at least he's 6'5", has some muscle on him, won't back down, will be aggressive as Emmert hits that.
They're just going to have to, I feel like they're, same with Bolver is doing the Raiders, they're going to have to double team, make him pass.
Thomas Fontleroy kicks it out to Isaac Johnson, and he hits a three.
But if I'm Kickpoo, I would double team. I feel like Bolver's shooting some threes, maybe contested threes is better than Emmert just bullying, having his way, getting pretty much a guaranteed two.
And a three Bolivar's way.
Connolly Garrison answers right back. Only a one-point game. 40-39 is Blaise. He's going to host a three.
Air ball.
Not a good
shot.
He
has not shot well at all today.
As Kruger pull up three. Not what Kickapoo needed there.
And just like that, Bolivar has the lead. And two straight threes by the Bolivar Liberators has Kickapoo down by two.
40-42. See if Kickapoo can keep the composure. We're probably going to look to go to Jared Ritter
Cameron
here.
Davis, pop and lock, made
big
it.
Shot. That's what they need. Need to score there. Get some momentum back. So
that's okay. They tied the game up. It's 42-42. That's all they needed.
Garrett's a nice drive.
And an easy drive for Bolivar. Rodney Garrison has actually had a pretty successful and quiet night so far. He scored 10 points for Liberators.
Indeed he has. As Bolivar retakes the lead, see if Kickapoo can answer. Ties game back up or possibly take the lead.
Cameron Davis on Emmert. Tries to get through. Blakesy back to Davis. Davis shoots.
They left him wide open. Nails a three. Emmert backed off of Davis after he kicked it out. Well, Davis open, he's had a very good second half, keeping Kickapoo in this game and also giving them the lead.
And now it's 45-44. Kickapoo Chiefs lead the Bolivar Liberators. So a great game so far in the seventh place game of the TOC in the consolation bracket.
As
Kruger pull up three.
Nice looking shot there. As Bolivar's going to take a timeout. Bolivar with a two-point lead.
That looks a little
45.
Bit looks like a little bit of Steph Curry, don't you agree, Charles?
Well, it was a quick shot, and he nailed it. I mean, obviously, it's not an NBA three. It's a high school three, but still a nice-looking shot there.
And just like we stated all game long, Kruger has probably the nicest and prettiest shot of the Bolivar Liberators.
And indeed he does. But this is not what we want. We want the Chiefs to win.
No, the Chiefs need to win. And so far, if the game ended right now, it would be 47-45 Liberators. So
not really what we envision. Not what we want.
No.
Let's hope the Chiefs can do something here out of the timeout, get the lead back, or get a score, get some momentum. Got to get some stops while we're scoring the last either four or five possessions, haven't kept track, but they've gotten a score. No defensive stops lately for Kickapoo. That's why Bolivar has crept into this lead. We'll see what Kickapoo can do here. As Robertson has checked in for Kickapoo, as I see, as Isaac Johnson is going to come back in after he just got subbed out.
Blakesy to Davis. Davis looks like he wants to shoot it. And he kicks it out to Robertson. Robertson wanted to shoot it.
And now Davis, no, he's not going to shoot it. And he turns it over. Probably should have had the shots when they could have.
Yeah, and a foul.
Balver and momentum's in their favor definitely right now.
Yeah, I think we should be more confident in their three-point shooting. Even though it's not the best, at least get a shot up instead of turning it over.
This is going to be a good game. It's going to come down to the last minute. I can just feel it. That was
and
not a pretty-looking shot
there.
That
was not a pretty-looking free throw shot. No.
Looked like a Matt Breckenridge free throw. Did I say so myself?
You know what? I don't think it looks like that. I think I shoot better than that, so if you guys want to see me shoot some baskets, you know, you can always come over to the Y.
We'll record you.
5:30 a.m.
We'll record you if you want.
You can record me if you want to. But, yeah, at least he hits the second pair, the last shot of his three throw.
To make still it a 48-45
game,
though,
one possession. Thomas Fauntleroy with the two-pointer. No good.
Ritter
tried
to fire to
get
rebound,
it, but no.
They were saying just ground down rebounds. As ball worth a two-point lead and the ball really been their third quarter. They've really dominated.
Kruger drives.
Going to drive it. And that was
no,
not a very good,
good
shot. Good defense there by Isaac Johnson. Holding his ground, forcing a tough shot. That's surprising from Balver. They don't really take shots like that. They really move the ball. We'll see here what Kickapoo does. The third quarter is going to wind down. Kickapoo's going to hold it for the last shot. Three can tie it. The two will make it a one-point game.
I'd say settle for the two here. Be down one unless there's a really good three-point shot
here. I have a feeling they're going to shoot the threes. Johnson's going to take a shot. Not a good shot. That will count if it goes. Looked like it was on target. A little nervous-wracking there.
So, as the third quarter comes to an end, the Chiefs of Kickapoo, 45, and the Liberators of Bolivar, 48. So, the three-point lead for Bolivar.
We'll be back after this.
We'll be back after this.
You're watching Chief TV. Chief TV. Chief TV. Up here in Studio 241, you've got every opportunity to become a media expert. Whether you're interested in traditional broadcast journalism, news reporting, or short filmmaking, music video, animation, audio production, make a great demo CD. Up here in Chief TV, you'll learn it all. In other words, we make your YouTube videos professional grade. Consider Chief TV broadcast journalism when you're scheduling. Broadcast journalism 1 and 2 count for credit under communication arts. And they teach you career skills you can't find anywhere else here at KHS. At Kickapoo Chief TV, we do stuff that matters. Join broadcast journalism today. You're watching Chief TV. Up here in Studio 241, you've got every opportunity to become a media expert. Whether you're interested in traditional broadcast journalism, news reporting, or short filmmaking, music video, animation, audio production, make a great demo CD. Up here in Chief TV, you'll learn it all.
All right, we're back with the Kickapoo Chiefs and the Bolivar Liberators for the final quarter of this game. 8 minutes left to separate these two teams, and right now, Bolivar has the lead, 48-45.
Does he have a new face on Hayden Schmitz for Kickapoo? I haven't
Hayden
seen him
Schmitz
yet. He's
takes
got
a three, and
he
makes
it.
Wow.
Right off the bench. Hasn't
right
even
off
come
the
in.
Bench. I think you might call him a super sub.
If I do say it, that was big. He hadn't even played. He just checked in first time. He makes a three, and it's
and Thomas Fauntleroy with the steal. Great athleticism by Thomas Fauntleroy.
That's what the guy do. The guy started double
and Hayden Schmitz thought about a three. I think he should have taken it because he hit the first one he hit.
I don't know.
It
might have been the best shot.
Takes a, no, he doesn't. Ritter takes a three.
No foul
called. Looks like
called.
He got fouled, but no. Rippey is
furious.
Isaac Johnson
saves
it.
As they're going to travel on Schmitz. But a good start to the fourth quarter. Double teaming.
Definitely
Emmert.
Thought Jared Ritter got fouled, though, on that 3-point
Yeah, it looked
attempt.
Like there was contact after it. No call. But Emmert, double team, they forced the turnover. That's what they got to do. And that's what I think Kickapoo is going to do. If he gets down low, too close for Kickapoo, they're going to double team. Just like this. Not letting him go anywhere. See, good recovery by Kickapoo. That's what they got to do. They got to double team. Emmert can't shoot those. Ritter acknowledges that and gets out on him. There's a
three ball and no good, and rebound by Johnson.
Colin Garrison with the three, but that was no good.
So Kickapoo can regain the lead. Hayden Schmitz with the three.
No, missed not it. That time. There's a foul on Johnny Scott holding Ritter, trying to go up for the rebound.
That was not smart. There was no play around that at all, and he just decided to not unlock his arms. So
well, I think there would have been if he didn't hold him because Ritter might have been able to get that ball.
Maybe, but Kickapoo got bailed out there, and they get the possession again. So
we'll
see if Kickapoo can regain the lead here.
Here's Ritter.
Taking on Johnny Scott.
Nice little pump fake.
And in.
Bounce.
Nice roll.
Skookoo retakes the 50-48 lead.
And just like that, instead of being down three, they're up two on a little 5-0 run by the Chiefs.
Start off this fourth quarter on a good note. We'll see if Kickapoo
can
hold
on.
Very good
for Coach Rippey's men. If they can keep doing this, I think
Kruger. Nice
Kruger with a pretty move.
Got Ritter to bite on that fake. Got the easy layup. As Cameron Davis is going to pull up for three, and he nails it. Huge shot as Coach Rick is going to call a timeout. That's what they needed. Chiefs now with a three-point lead. 5-5 to go. Think they can hang on, Matty B?
I'm really hoping they can. I'm really hoping. Cameron Davis, though, with 14 points. That's a big contributor to Jared Ritter's 19. So.
Ritter only been held to 2 points, but other guys have been able to step up and kick with three people in double digits. Isaac Johnson, Cameron Davis to go along with Jared Ritter, both
but
in double digits.
Bryce Kruger and Emmert really pacing this ball over offense with 15 and 21 points respectively.
Ooh, I really hope the kick can hold on. We want to see a win, don't we, Matty B?
Yeah, we do. We don't want to be that team that goes 0-3.
No.
We're hoping our counterparts, Bolivar, will go 0-3.
Yeah.
But, of course, we wish everyone could win in a tournament, but it's not the case. So
kind of wish we weren't playing each other. We both would have won yesterday's games or the games before. But this is how it goes, you know. Tournament champions, some very good teams, very talented. Ooh, it's going to be a good finish. I'm excited. We get to see a close game. The last two games have kind of been, you know, one-sided and not in Kickapoo's favor of this game. See what happens. I will say this, though. Not much. The student section really didn't show up today for Kickapoo. Could have used the support, but in the last play's game, no one really wants to watch that.
And
but, hey, we could get a win, you know.
It's kind of a shame.
That's good pressure by Cameron Davis there.
And Jared Ritter was on Emmert. And just waiting for a shot here.
Emmert
with the ball.
He's going to go quick.
Oh,
Ritter,
rejection
block
by Ritter. And Emmert still tries to get the ball. And Emmert with the foul. Sorry, not Emmert with the foul. Emmert with the foul.
Draws
shot.
The foul.
Draws the foul. And he will get a pair at the free
really,
throw line.
Really fighting hard there. Could have gone away with that. Sound like you're wondering if you're Coach Rippey. See if he can do here. So he's going to make the first one, cut down to two again. It would have been nice if Kickapoo could have gotten that steal or not letting Bolivar score there. They had hands on the ball, but just couldn't come up with it. As the arena got very quiet for the second free throw, which is good. 1 point game.
Well, folks, I'm glad you're enjoying our broadcast and enjoying a good game of basketball as Thomas Fauntleroy kicks it out to Schmitz. Schmitz to
back
Johnson and back to Thomas Fauntleroy.
Schmitz
with the three.
His
second three by Schmitz.
This has been a very good sub. Maybe he gotten some playing time earlier. Two big threes. That's six
points. And maybe
points.
Coach Rippey later on this season will play Schmitz just for the three-point offense that he has.
I feel like the main reason is he's a big body and Kickapoo needs big bodies is they're going to double team again.
And Schmitz has lost his man. Leaves him open.
Garrison.
And
no good,
no
but Kruger
good, but
on the offense.
Kruger with the rebound.
But throws it away.
Thomas Fauntleroy with the steal. And he looks like he wants to take it to the hoop.
And
a block. So
good,
Thomas Fauntleroy will get a pair of free throws.
Good play there by Kickapoo. The double team on Emmert is working as they've got some turnovers. Good defensive adjustment there by Rippey, Coach Rippey. That's two free throws now. Thomas Fauntleroy will shoot two. You a little tired there?
Yeah, just a little tired.
You didn't get any good sleep last night?
Well.
Misses it.
I did get some good sleep, but
what?
You know,
just
the afternoon. You know what I'm saying? Makes us tired for some reason, but his game is definitely not tiring at all.
He misses both.
And Tyler Funtoy misses two free throws. So
remember, if it's a 2-point loss, or if something like that happens, those two free throws. Remember that could have won the game.
Could have tied the game.
True.
But, you know, that's okay. There's still 4.5 minutes left, so we'll see what happens.
Only 4.5 minutes left on our broadcasting. It ended so quick. Can't believe it's already almost over. Ballers going to set up their offense. Working it around the perimeter. As Bryce Krueger drives it in. No good.
Gets his own rebound.
Good hustle.
And
fight for
the ball.
But
no, he gets it. And a foul.
Good hustle by Bryce Krueger there.
If you're a coach, you really like that hustle. And you reward a player with playing time. And that's what the Bolivar coach has been doing, is rewarding Bryce Krueger with playing time.
Yeah. What's his third? Kickoo should have had that, though.
They should have. But you know what? Congratulations to Bryce Krueger for getting that rebound. I mean, missing his shot and then getting it again.
Yeah, congratulations.
Congratulations.
And the second one is
he makes two of them.
So two free throws that could have gone for Kickapoo, instead go for Bolivar. A 4-point swing there. 2-point lead now for Kickapoo. 54-56.
Davis top of the shot.
Davis baseline.
Goes
to
Ritter.
And there's a foul on Bolivar. Ballmer's not very happy with that call. But Ritter, he's really been quiet the second half.
But you know what? I think I'm okay with that call, considering we are Kickapoo fans. But I agree, there was definitely contact by Johnny Scott, and there was no charge or anything. That was just a foul by Johnny Scott.
But Ritter. Jim Ritter been only held to 2 points the second half. Ballmer done a good job containing him. Has Amber been held to 8 points?
Amber's been held to 8 points, so still
second half, but
still an improvement from last half, but compared to Jared Ritter's 3 points.
Now a foul on Schmitz, but Kickapoo with three missed free throws could have a 6-point lead right now. With 3:50 to go, we'll see.
We'll see if those free throws become costly.
There's a little bit of some pressure here by Kickapoo. Let's hope that Kickapoo can edge out this win. Ooh, and a travel there. Johnny Scott, critical travel, unforced there. That's not what Bolivar needed there as the coach. You can tell he's didn't even get a shot. Break for Kickapoo, good defense. Strength has had a very big impact on this game for Kickapoo. Really giving him life as we're going
to
go
to
Ritter.
Ritter kicks back out to Davis.
A three bang, huge shot. 6-point lead, timeout by Kickapoo. 60-54.
As you can see,
this game, Kickapoo, if
Davis
they can hold on.
Davis is fired up. I mean, I would too. He just hit a really big
17
three.
Points.
That makes it a 6-point lead for the Chiefs, and he has 17 points, only 3 points behind Jared Ritter for the high score for the Kickapoo Chiefs. So, Cameron Davis, congratulations to you. You're having a great night.
Yes, you are. Really giving Kickapoo a 6-point. If they can hold on and get the win, that'd be great. But those three missed free throws, it could be a 9-point game here. More pressure on Bolivar, but we'll see if Kickapoo can hold on here.
So let me ask you a question right here, Chucky.
Okay.
The last 3 minutes, before the last 3 minutes are over, as of right now, who's your MVP of the game?
For either team?
Either team. Overall, who's your MVP of the game?
I would say Emmert for Bolivar, because he's really been the driving force from the problems that Kickapoo has had. Up, you know, for three quarters, the fourth quarter, they've been able to adjust, but really is what's kept him in the game with his hustle and, you know, all those offensive rebounds and his scoring. Really what's getting Bolivar some life. How about you, Matty B?
Well, you know, I was going to go with maybe Cameron Davis. I think he's been, even though he isn't the high scorer for Kickapoo, he's, you know, hit some clutch threes and actually is doing a good job and playing defense, getting some steals. So
and a turnover.
For me, it would be Cameron Davis as my MVP.
And now Barberson's going to a little bit of a press, but turnover there, forced out of bounds.
So let's see if they can create a turnover on their press. And they get it to Isaac Johnson. Isaac Johnson will dribble it down the floor. And travel.
Looked like a little bit of a push there, but pretty good defense there by Ballbird. Forced a turnover, giving him some life still. But Hayden Schmitz, you can't forget him. He might be the MVP. His two threes are what is Kickapoo's leader now. If he hadn't come in, it would be a tie game. We'll see what Ballver does here.
I mean, they were a clutch. I give him that. But my MVP is still Cameron Davis.
And foul. We're going back down to Emirat. But fun fact, I don't think Ballver's made any subs this half. Same five guys all of this second half. They're going hard. But again, going down to Emirat. Won't able to get the double team in time. Had the foul. And a break there as he misses the first one. Lucky there.
Definitely can agree with that statement.
You enjoying this broadcasting, Matt? And you think this is fun? Oh, and he misses both. Huge. Ooh, and
break.
They get the rebound.
Yeah, broadcasting is pretty fun, you know. I mean, we've just been balling it up, as they say.
Balling it. We're ballers.
Even though we've had some technical difficulties the past 2 days, today has been a breeze. There's been no technical difficulties. And Thomas Fauntleroy down the lane with the jam. Woo!
That was pretty. Haven't seen a jam from Kickapoo.
Man,
Kickapoo, he's athletic.
Thomas Fauntleroy just jammed with authority there, saying, get out of my house.
But you can't let up your Kickapoo. This is still a game.
And Emirat.
He's just,
no,
oh,
rejected by Ritter.
Kickapoo with an 8-point lead. They still got to be smart here. Can't let up.
Yeah, eight point game still, but, you know, it looks like Bolivar just has no answers.
And there's a foul.
Emirat fouled Jared Ritter.
But, ooh. Kickapoo is starting to swing in their favor. What a dunk. The lane just opened up, and Thomas Fauntleroy just came right down, dropped the sledgehammer. Kickapoo still can't let up. There's still time here as we're going to call a timeout. I think that's what Coach Rip is going to aggress. Don't let up. Still play hard. We got to be smart with it. Can't give Bolivar any chance here with an 8-point lead. Their largest of the night with 1:58 to go. Chief TV will be right back after this short timeout to bring you the end of this game.
You're watching Chief TV. Up here in Studio 2, Chief TV. Up here in Studio 2, Chief TV. Up here in Studio 241, you've got every opportunity to become a media expert. Whether you're interested in traditional broadcast journalism news reporting, or short filmmaking, music video, animation, audio production, make a great demo CD. Up here in Chief TV, you'll learn it all. In other words, we make your YouTube videos professional grade. Consider Chief TV broadcast journalism when you're scheduling. Broadcast journalism 1 and 2 count for credit under communication arts, and they teach you career skills you can't find anywhere else here at KHS. At Kickapoo Chief TV, up here in studio.
And we are back.
All right, we are back.
8-point lead for Kickapoo.
Two minutes remaining,
pretty much.
And an 8-point lead.
Schmitz.
And Schmitz, no,
no.
Ritter Jared Ritter
gets
the rebound and kicks it back out to
it.
Cameron Davis.
Huge
nice
for
play
Kickapoo.
By Jared Ritter.
As Kickapoo can waste some time and get another possession to score, really putting the pressure on Ballover here. It's really the first offensive rebound I've seen for a while on Kickapoo. It was huge. Just Schmitz wide open. Good.
No,
that
looked good
huge.
To me, but.
That was huge. That would have been huge. Kickapoo can't let up here. That would have extended the lead to double digits. Now it's time for Ballver here.
Ballver with
a three.
Makes it.
That's not what you need if you're Kickapoo. Colin Garrison nails it. Ooh.
That makes it a 5-point game. Kickapoo Chiefs still lead, but not as comfortable lead.
Ballver's not going to go away.
Sadly, they are not going away.
We want a Kickapoo win here. That's what we want.
That's right, we want to see a W up next to Kickapoo Chiefs' name.
In the Tournament of Champions, too. It's always good. Cheerleaders are going to do their thing here. Can't see him, though, but that's all right. No, that's okay,
there
Matt.
There you go, there you go.
Yeah, you still can't even really see him, but.
You can't really see him, but, you know, at least you can see at least a couple of them. Since Chucky wants to bring him up.
Chucky? You mean Chuck Wagon?
Chucky, Chuck Wagon, you have many names.
Matt Chu?
You know, they call me Manny B instead, but
no.
You know, that's okay.
We can name each other what we want. It's all right.
I don't know about that one. I think I'm Matty B, yeah.
MM?
You
like
nope.
That? No.
Nope. Definitely Matty B.
Matty B. Well, all right. You change Chucky to Chuck Wagon. Kyle Williams gave me that name, but here we go back. Chiefs got to inbound the ball. Got
to
be
they
smart here.
It to Thomas Fuentleroy. Gets it back to Davis.
Can't afford a turnover. Good job handling the press. They're going to try and trap, and there's a foul. Good job of Kickapoo to be able to handle that press, not turn it over. Got to keep your composure here. Still definitely a game.
And the Liberators are the only ones in the bonus, and now the Chiefs will be in the bonus on the next foul. So.
Ooh, dangerous pass there. A lot of trapping and a foul.
Ooh, that did not look like a foul to me.
That looked like all ball.
That looked all ball. So a lucky break for Kickapoo. That shouldn't have been a foul.
One and one, sorry. Hopefully he can make these, but yeah, that looked clean to me. Kickapoo got a break there. That could have been transition and another score for Bolivar. As he gets
makes
the roll.
It.
That was critical there. Huge free throws. Cameron Davis, number 5, the junior guard. We've got a lot of talent along with Jared Ritter. Very good junior duo here. As he makes the second one. 7-point lead. Get a stop here. That'll really, really put you in a good position if you're Kickapoo. Ooh, back door. Emirates gets the two. Isaac Johnson up ahead to Cameron Davis. To Frontoy, to Ritter. Foul and one. Not a smart foul there.
That is Emirates' third.
Should just probably let him have the two there. Or at least make a strong foul so he can't get it up like that. And now Kickapoo has a if they can score back, if Bolivar scores, then they'll be just fine. Under a minute to go as Ritter knocks down the free throw. He has 23. 8-point lead with 53 seconds to go. It's looking pretty good for the Chiefs here. Hopefully they don't let up. Bolivar's going to have to probably shoot a three really soon. That's what they do. And no good there. And the rebound. Frontoy cannot save it. Still be Bolivar ball.
Frontoy cannot save the rebound.
The rebound.
And so it will be Bolivar's ball, but I believe Bolivar has taken a timeout to discuss their next play call, considering there is only 39 seconds left, and the Chiefs are up by 8, 67-59.
Been a hard-fought game by the Chiefs. Very good, much better than the other two games. Bolivar, pretty good team. Hopefully we can hold off Bolivar here and get the win, get the W, go 1-2. What are your thoughts on the game, Matty B?
I thought the Chiefs did a lot better job of swinging the ball around, cutting, slashing, actually posted up a little bit. Finally controlled the big man, Emmert. I mean, he's only scored 10 points in this second half.
Only about
so.
4 in the fourth quarter. Really been a non-factor.
Yeah, so really good job by the Chiefs for the fourth quarter adjustment. So I think the Chiefs really they can build on this, considering Bolivar will be one of the teams that they play in Missouri. So as Missouri competition goes, Kickapoo is in a good spot and beat a local power.
This will be a very good win for Kickapoo if they can hold it off here with 39 seconds to go.
And we could officially call them the winners of the Blue and Gold Tournament.
Yes, we can. And 7th place of the TLC.
So kind of a bittersweet thing considering they're only in 7th place, but, you know, still good to say that you've beaten Bolivar. You have that on your resume. You are technically the overall Blue and Gold champs. So good storyline here for Kickapoo.
They get a stop here. I think this game is pretty much over as Kruger is going to hoist the three. And no good.
Almost made it. Emmert
fighting
controls.
For the rebound.
No
blocked
good.
By
blocked by Jared Ritter. And a foul by Emmert.
29 seconds to go. That's very good defensive play there. But the player of the game, at least in the fourth quarter, Hayden Smith coming on, playing some good defense, helping guard Emmert, making those two threes, really giving the Chiefs momentum in this fourth quarter to build this lead.
I would definitely agree that he could be considered a fourth quarter MVP candidate. The other one is Cameron Davis with his clutch three-pointers as well.
Jared Ritter knocks down the first three throw. He can go for 25 on the night, having a very good TOC. Jared Ritter is actually averaging 18 points a game this tournament. So he's about to run an average about 20 points in this tournament. Very good. A 10-point lead with 25 seconds to go. Looking very good for Kickapoo. Time just going to wind down. Bolivar blocked and one. Wasn't really a need for a foul there. Just kind of let him get the layup.
Yeah, you know, still need to do some competition here, and I don't believe that foul will really have much weight considering it is 69-61 Chiefs with the lead.
With 18 seconds to
and
go.
And he connects.
On the free throw. Going to try and get a little trap here if they can. And there's a foul. And I think that will pretty much officially put a wrap on this game with a Kickapoo in, Chiefs.
I think it will.
You do?
I think the Chiefs will win this game if Cameron Davis makes his first free throw, since he's in the bonus, and then makes the second one. I think this game will come out of reach, and there's the first one. Knocked down and good.
Cameron Davis had a very good game. 20 points.
20 points, maybe 21 here if he connects.
Very, very good performance as he knocks him down.
Knocks it down. There we go.
71-62 for Kickapoo with 14 seconds to go. Looks like Kickapoo is going to be the official Blue and Gold winner. They're going to take 7th place in the TOC over Bolivar. Hard-fought game. Good
They'll
game.
They'll go 1-2 in the TOC.
Kruger knocks it down.
And there we have it, folks. A Chiefs
win.
We have a 71-64 Chiefs win over the Bolivar Liberators.
Tough game. Shout out to Bolivar.
Tough loss to Bolivar, but shout out to them. I mean, they play with heart, with passion. They didn't want to lose either the Chiefs, but
we're able to
you know,
get it done.
When it's all said and done, the Chiefs come out on top, 71-64, claim the blue, the official blue and gold champions, and the 7th place.
In this year's tournament champions.
Exactly.
It was such a blast to be able to broadcast these last three games.
And we'll give you a little pregame in about 2 minutes.
And this will be the end of us.
And that will be the end
TOC.
Of our stint for the TOC. So,
we hope.
And
we'll see you
about
back in
2 to 3 minutes. We'll see you.
Welcome to Kickapoo High School in Kickapoo High School in Springfield, Kickapoo High School in Springfield, Missouri. This is our new digital high-definition student center. This is our student body. Every day, 2,000 students and staff members walk through these hallways and gather here for lunch. What does that mean for your local business? A captive audience ready to watch your promotion every single school day. Kickapoo Media prides itself on producing great student content with a professional touch. We're ready to help your company grow by showing your advertisement right here in the hallways every single day. We're a nonprofit organization and we're tax deductible friendly. So if you'd like to help out Kickapoo High School and the community you work in, we'd sure love to help your business grow. Hi, I'm Kyle Loudis. I'm the director here at Kickapoo High School Broadcast Communications. For the last 10 years, we've been raising funds for our students through local commercials and advertisements right here in the hallways at the POO. My students are ready, willing, and able to produce your high school-centric commercial. You may not know this, but Chief TV broadcast journalism costs nearly $6,000 per semester to operate. So consider helping us with a donation. So that's the pitch. Hopefully we can help you out, we can shoot a commercial for you, or you can give us a pre-produced commercial you've already had done. Either way, consider showing your commercial right here in the hallways of Kickapoo High School. Thanks, gang. We'll see you soon. Welcome to Kickapoo High School in Springfield, Missouri. This is our new digital high-definition student center. This is our student body. Every day, 2,000 students and staff members walk through these hallways and gather here for lunch. What does that mean for your local business? A captive audience ready to watch your promotion every single school day. Kickapoo Media prides itself on producing great student content with a professional touch. We're ready to help your company grow by showing your advertisement right here in the hallways every single day. We're a nonprofit organization and we're tax deductible friendly. So if you'd like to help out Kickapoo High School and the community you work in, we'd sure love to help your business grow. Hi, I'm Kyle Loudis. I'm the director here at Kickapoo High School Broadcast Communications. For the last 10 years, we've been raising funds for our students through local commercials and advertisements right here in the hallways at the POO. My students are ready, willing, and able to produce your high school-centric commercial. You may not know this, but Chief TV broadcast journalism costs nearly $6,000 per semester to operate. So consider helping us with a donation. So that's the pitch. Hopefully we can help you out, we can shoot a commercial for you, or you can give us a pre-produced commercial you've already had done. Either way.
All right. We're back here with the Kickapoo 71-64 win over the ball over Liberators. Good win for Kickapoo. They don't go 0-3. They're not that team. They'll get 7th place. Official winners of the blue and gold. Anything to say about...
Honestly, I'm really proud about how Kickapoo played today. Their 3-point percentage was actually pretty good. For the game, they were about 40%, so that's better than last two games, and they made 9 out of 23 threes. So that's really good. Overall, they shot 51%, so good for them. Honestly, Kickapoo played really well. Definitely outplayed Bolivar, and it shows by the score, 71-64. My MVP of the game is Cameron Davis, as you all know. Definitely played a heck of a game, made some quality threes. So no offense to Bolivar at all. They played an excellent game, played with heart, with passion. But Kickapoo definitely deserved the win, and they got it. Charles?
All right. If I just say... post-game thoughts, the second half, the third quarter was a little shaky, but they really came out in the fourth quarter. Hayden Schmitz came in, hit two big threes for Kickapoo. They were able to stop Emmer, and his dominant play with the double team only held him to 4 points in that fourth quarter. They really took over in the fourth quarter, and if I had to say so myself, Cameron Davis would probably be my MVP. Really played well, especially in that fourth quarter. To go on with Jared Rivers, 25, he had 21. Made some good plays in turnover. It was just really good game for Kickapoo. Hard fought. Bolivar really played well. Both teams very, very good. I think they can make runs in the postseason. But just, yeah.
But back to the original grind for Kickapoo. So congrats to them. Finished 1-2 in the tournament. 7th place team. And with that, we'll leave you. The next game up is Christ the King Royals and Rainier Beach Gales.
And with that, 5th place game.
The big game at TOC. With that,
sadly,
I'm Maddie B.
Chuck Wagon, sadly, Chiefs.
We're signing off
broadcast.
For the last time from the TOC. We hope to see you again for another Kickapoo home game.
That's what we want. All right.
We'll see you next time.
Have a good night.
Good night.